الدجال will emerge. Will emerge at a time when there is starvation and famine in earth. في سنن ابن ماجه وصحيح ابن خزيمة من حديث أبي أمامة الباهلي رضي الله عنه. Listen to this. Allah سبحانه وتعالى will command the earth 3 years before the emerging of the Dajjal. The first year to withhold third of its vegetation. And will command the sky to withhold third of its rain. The second year, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command earth to withhold 2/3 of its vegetation, and will command the sky to withhold 2/3 of its rain. The third year, which is the year right before the emergence of the Dajjal, the coming out of the Dajjal, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will command earth to withhold all of its vegetation. No produce. No food. And will command the sky, the heavens, to withhold all of its rain. فسأل الصحابة النبي. اسمع عني هذا الكلام. The companions asked the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what is the nutrition then, O Messenger of Allah? قال التكبير والتسبيح والتحميد والتهليل. The nutrition will be Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Allahu Akbar, Subhanallah, 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 Alhamdulillah, 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 Allahu Akbar, Allah, La ilaha illallah, La ilaha illallah. This is the nutrition. في صحيح البخاري فاطمة رضي الله عنها, فاطمة الزهراء بنت رسول الله, the daughter of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, she went to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and she said to him, O Messenger of Allah, can you give me a servant to help me with the housework? I'm getting tired. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told her, go home. At night, he went to their house. He found her and Ali, radiyallahu an Ali, in bed. He went in between them. And he said to her, أَلَا أَدُلُّكِ عَلَى خَيْرٍ مِّنْ خَادِمٍ. Shall I tell you about something much better than a servant? Before you go to sleep, say Subhanallah 33 times. Subhanallah, Subhanallah, Subhanallah. Say Alhamdulillah 33 times. And say Allahu Akbar 34 times. What is the relationship between the request? Huh? You getting it or no? Assalamu alaikum. You getting the connection there? Huh? You getting the point? الإيمان, إيمان. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم used to go around his wives, and I'm not gonna be explicit in this, with one غسل. One غسل. His wives. ها؟ إيمان. المعاصي affects your physical body. Sins affects your body. Iman actually gives you strength. Here they are, their nutrition is al-adhkar. Huh? All right. Let's move on. Another thing. Here's the beauty, and I love that. I love this piece. Ya Allah, this piece is so wonderful. The people will be two camps. إيمان لا نفاق فيه وكفر لا إيمان فيه. Pure hypocrisy or pure disbelief. ما فيش نفاق خلاص. النفاق ده مشكلة. Hypocrisy is a killer. It bothers me. اللهم جنبنا النفاق يا رب العالمين. And this is taken from a hadith by Abdullah ibn Amr ibn al-As, the meanings of which في مستدرك الحاكم. طيب, number three. So we finished two now. We still have eight to go. All right? You're going to hang around? Number three, his physical appearance. Let me ask you this question. When you look at a person, what is the first thing that you see? No, in the face. What is the first? Eyes. Subhanallah. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala places the defection of the Dajjal where? Ya Allah. For the blind. You need this as a fitna that somebody will ask you to worship him. He will tell you, I'm Allah. I am God. He will tell you, I'm God. I'm your Lord. Believe that I'm Allah. You're Allah. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells his companions, I will say something to you that no messenger told his nations before me. Huwa a'war. He is one-eyed. Wa inna Allah laysa bi'a'war. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is not one-eyed. Yani if you are Allah, I mean, give me a break. Fix your eyes. I mean, you're giving me two eyes, and I'm created by you, correct? You created me, right? Correct? You're Allah. You created me. Huh? What happened to you? But yet, a lot of people will fall in the trap. Wallahi, ana aqul lak, after this description, only a person in whose heart is a disease will follow him. Here is the wording regarding his eyes. في البخاري ومسلم قال رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم حديث أنس بن مالك الدجال ممسوح العين. الدجال, his eye is braided. His right eye, one of the wording. His left eye, one of the wording. But the bottom line is one of his eyes is braided, looking like a floating grape, and the other one is also defective. مكتوب بين عينيه, written between his two eyes, كافر. وفي رواية with Muslim, in a wording with Muslim, hadith Anas, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam said this, مكتوب بين عينيه, written between his two eyes, كافر. يا الله, ما هو اسمع, اسمع الرواية القادمة هذه. Look at the third wording. Good question. Who's going to read this? The wording of حذيفة في صحيح مسلم. He said, يقرأه كل مؤمن كاتب وغير كاتب. Only the believers. And that's why I told you we need to study this, because if you don't have iman, you're not going to read كافارة. You're going to read, give me a hug, Dajjal. Wallah, I tell you, so one of the scholars actually said this. If a Dajjal comes out right now, بالروح والدم نفديك يا دجال. Like if he goes and he nominates himself to the election or something. Huh? We sacrifice ourselves for you, oh Dajjal. Because the people do not know anything about him. You cannot have a shaky faith when he's out. ثلاثة إذا خرج. Three things that if they come out, لا تنفع نفسا إيمانها. Your iman is not going to benefit you if you start to believe. Here is very quickly other descriptions. A very well-built man. Muscular. You know these guys, musculars? They walk like this. That type. With a reddish complexion. You know, very white. To the, like the people in Scotland and Finland. These areas. Curly hair. Two snakes. Rasulullah actually described them like snakes mixing with one another, curly. Very short. Qasir. Afhaj. You know what Afhaj is? His legs are like bow, babu, something like that, boot. Boo? Bow, like a bow. You know, he walks like this. Has a wide neck. You know the neck that is like, there is no neck like, neck like part of the body? Like a very wide neck, like part of the body? Like this, like you don't see a neck? His forehead is prominent. Ajla. Alhamdulillah, he will have no children. Aqim. Number four, where will Dajjal emerge? قال صلى الله عليه وسلم والحديث في سنن الترمذي وسنن ابن ماجه ومستدرك الحاكم سيخرج الدجال من بلد في المشرق اسمها خراسان. الدجال will come out from a place in the east called Khurasan, known now by Bergia, Iran. Who are the followers? Number five. Let's get going here. Number five. Who are the followers of Dajjal? أكثر أتباع الدجال من يهود. Because هذا هو ملكهم المنتظر. This is the awaited king for the Jews. قال صلى الله عليه وسلم كما في صحيح مسلم من حديث أنس يتبع الدجال. الدجال will be followed. 70,000 من يهود أصفهان أو أصبهان. الدجال will be followed by 70,000 from the Jews of Asfahan. يرتدون الطياليس, wearing their clothes. Also there is a wording that الدجال will be followed by a lot of women. Number six. And listen carefully to this one. This is just a taste, a taste of the fitna of the Dajjal. بس شوف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم تلزي وات في صحيح مسلم حديث حذيفة ابن اليمان. حذيفة أعلم الناس بالفتن. He said this. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said this. لأنا أعلم من الدجال بما مع الدجال من الفتن. شوف النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. By Allah, I know that which with the Dajjal of trials more than the Dajjal himself. أشهد أن محمد رسول الله. ها؟ معه نهران يجريان. With him will be two rivers flowing. أحدهما رأي العين ماء أبيض one of these rivers, you will see it with your own eyes. رأي العين. White, cold, good water. والآخر, and the other river, رأي العين, نار تأجج. And the other river, you will see it with your own eyes, a raging fire or a molten lava. Lava? فإن أدرك أحدكم الدجال, if a Dajjal catches any of you, فليأتي النهر الذي يراه نارا. Make sure that you drink from the river that you see a raging fire, not the other one. And he given us some tools to help us. وليغمض عيني. Close your eyes. Don't look at it. Don't look at the river because it's fire. وليطأطئ رأسه. And look down. وليشرب. You will find it cool, cold, sweet water. Brothers and sisters in Islam, you need to understand that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give Ad-Dajjal, the Antichrist, these powers. And that explains to you that a lot of people who do a lot of innovations and they show powers to prove to you that they have access to some sort of divine. And in fact, they receive help from shayateen. Here are some of the powers that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give, will empower Ad-Dajjal with. One, the ability to travel rapidly throughout earth. Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, كما في حديث النواس بن سمعان رضي الله عنه, was asked about his traveling speed. He said, كالغيث استدبرته الريح, like a wind driven rain or cloud. Travels through earth quickly. And he will not leave one place, but he will enter it. إلا مكة وطيبة. مكة والمدينة. He said there are angels guarding it, standing with swords. Every time I try to enter those two cities, they kick me away. حديث أنس بن مالك رضي الله عنه في البخاري ومسلم قال صلى الله عليه وسلم, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم says, ما من مدينة, there is no city, إلا وصيطأها الدجال, but the Dajjal will come into it. حتى ال village, that little small towns, he will come there. إلا مكة والمدينة. Number two, he will receive help from jinn. We know jinn are kafirs and Muslims. وأن منا الصالحون ومنا دون ذلك وأن منا المسلمون ومنا القاسطون. The evil of them, and here is, he will come to a Bedouin and he will tell him, your father and mother are dead, right? Yes. If I bring them back to life to you, will you believe that I'm Allah? شوف. He will say yes. Two jinni will take the shape of his father and mother. And guess, our son, this is Allah, worship him. Fitna, akhi, fitna. Fitna, huge fitna. Huge fitna. Imagine your dead parents come back to you to commit shirk. Of course, they are not the true ones. These are shayateen that are taking their what? Their shape and form. The creation of Allah will respond to him. في حديث النواس بن سمعان رضي الله عنه في صحيح الإمام مسلم, يأتي على القوم, he will come to a group of people, فيدعوهم للإيمان به, he will ask them to believe in him, فيؤمنون, they will believe, then he will command the heaven to rain and the earth to give them fruit and they will flourish. And he will come to other people and will invite them to believe in him as Allah. They will say, no, لا نؤمن بك, we will not believe in you. They will lose all their properties, all their money, all their animals. وينادي على الخربة أو الخربة, الخرابة, a deserted place. أخرجي, أخرجي كنوزك, bring out your treasures, and it will bring out treasures. فتتبعه كيعاسيب النخل, and it will follow him. He will be walking with a mountain of bread. Remember the 3 years, starvation, famine, a mountain of bread and a mountain of meat. Believe that I'm Allah, I'll give you food. If you don't, starve. Starve to death. Fitan. That is why, by the way, one of the tools of salvation from the Antichrist, not to come near him, because he will get to you. في سنن أبي داود, the prophet said that a person will approach him thinking that he can combat him. He cannot be deceived by him. And then at the end, he will be bound down to him. Because his job is to get you to disbelieve. That's his goal. He will bring back the dead. Bring back the dead. He will kill people and bring them back to life. في صحيح الإمام مسلم, حديث أبي سعيد الخدري, that one of the young men of Medina will come out to him. And the followers of Dajjal will say to him, are you going to believe in our Lord? You're going to meet him because you believe in him? And then this young man will say, ما بربي خفاء. This is not Allah. But this is again one man from the Ummah. One man from the Ummah. Dajjal will cut him into two halves. Will break him into two halves. From the skull down. And he will walk between those two halves. And then he will command him to come back to life. Rise again. He will rise. But the young man will rise, smiling and laughing, looking at him. هل تؤمن بي الآن أني الله? Do you believe that I'm Allah now? He will say, والله, by Allah, ما ازددت بك إلا يقين أنت الدجال الذي أخبرنا عنه رسول الله. By Allah, I have not increased but certainty in what the messenger said to us about you. You are the Antichrist. Then he will try to chop his neck. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will place a copper kind of shield around his neck. Then he will take him. He's so angry. Will take him and he will throw him in that fire with him. For the people, he's burning. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, by Allah, he is in Jannah. That young man is in Jannah. وَهُوَ خَيْرُ الشُّهَدَاءِ عِنْدَ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ خَيْرُ النَّاسِ شَهَادَةِ. And this is the best, this man, this young man, is the best martyr with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala.